Hey guys, Dion here. I accidentally used this bleaching product and something happened to my skin.
She is leaving and we are so sad.
When your hair's wet,
it's like you just came out the shower. You know what I think? Because she did. Fucking sad, our homies are leaving.
She's leaving too. We're gonna miss you.
Yeah. We had a good squad, but now it's all coming to an end, unfortunately. Yeah.
Where are we going? No hiding. She is also leaving us. And
Nah, he's staying with us. We kidnapped him, we took his passport, he ain't going nowhere.
And then we got this guy.
He's with us also, he's the team leader. So. And Jillian, get out here. We need some sunlight, you're like a vampire.
Jillian. We're gonna miss you. Seriously.
I'm gonna miss you too.
She's splitting the squad up. It's all good though. I have her passport, so she's not going nowhere.
And she's smoking a menthol right now. You know what I'm saying? Best cigarettes in the world.
It's only gum cigarette.
Gum cigarette?
What the hell did you just say?
What's a gum cigarette?
Let's go!
Alright. I'm fucked up. So, Dion got into a fucking scooter accident.
Are you serious? How you know? No, for real, don't play like that.
If you guys follow Dion on Instagram, you'll know that he is currently in the fucking hospital. He was driving at nighttime and fucking got into a scooter accident and got really fucked up.
Alright, yo, so basically I'm in the hospital right now. I'm in the Bangkok hospital in Chiang Mai. I got into a crazy scooter accident in Pai.
You got knocked the fuck out!
Fuck. I got about 30 stitches or 20 something stitches in my body. I got open wound. I got a really bad cut on the top of my hand. And both the top of my hands and the palm of my hand. And I think the worst, I mean, I've fractured my foot in three places. Worst for me is literally here on my ribs. All the way, it's basically my back and my ribs. I got stitches all the way up. I think I got about 10 or 15 there. Now the worst thing I remember about getting the stitches was they did not freeze me. They did not numb me. They did not put me out. Like, they just were stitching my open wounds and I was screaming my head off in so much pain. It was the worst like experience in my whole life. The accident was bad, but more, 20 times worse. It was horrible. But I mean, I'll be okay. Now, I know that my insurance is gonna cover basically all the hospital bills and stuff like that, but I was supposed to get surgery here and they gave me the bill for it. They just told me how much it was gonna cost and it was around like 215,000 baht. So I did the conversion and that's about $11,000 Canadian. So my insurance said they're not gonna cover that. So they recommended that I go fly home and do the surgery back home. So that's what I'm gonna do. I've been in the hospital now for about 4 days. I think this is the fourth day. And I got a really bad injury on my eye. I have blurry vision in this eye. I can't read, see small letters. Like, it's pretty bad. I thought it would be getting better, but it's not getting better. Like, I can open my eye and see, but I can't read. It's all blurry. So it's kind of scary. That's my number one fear, is losing my eye or losing my vision or something like that. The rest I know is gonna heal, it's gonna all be good, but my eyesight is the most important. And pain-wise, I am in a lot of pain right now. I won't lie, I am in a lot of pain. On a scale from 1 to 10, it's at like a 7 right now. I just woke up. The worst is the mornings when I wake up. My ribs, the back of my ribs hurt so much. Like, they just feel bruised, and like I feel like I have cuts, and I've been kind of just, there's no way to avoid it unless I lay on my side. But when I lay on my side, I feel like I'm stretching the wounds, or just, it's not straight, so it just does not feel good at all. It feels very, like, feels horrible. And I've been attached to an IV for quite a while now. They just disconnected it, but they've been giving me antibiotics and painkillers, and one of the painkillers is morphine. So I mean, I don't even know if it's fully working, because like, there's not one time where I don't feel pain. I'm always in pain. And but basically, to explain how this happened, how it went down, is I was driving my scooter going about 80. Now there was one of my homies driving on the left side of me. We drive on the left side, and we were doing this turn. Sorry. We were doing this turn like this, and he swerved out while I was right kind of in back of him, and he clipped my front tire, and my bike just went out, and I went flying to the right side. Now, luckily, there was no cars coming, so no one hit me while I was already on the ground or anything, but I slid all the way into, like, the bushes and the trees and shit. And, it was pretty bad, but there was these two German girls that heard the accident from, like, not too far away. And they came running, and they brought me to their, like, to the where they were staying. Like, tried to fix up my wounds a little bit. They gave me like alcohol and stuff, but such a shock too that I was walking on my broken foot. I didn't realize how bad it was. I thought I'd be okay. My one eye could not see out of it at all. They called the ambulance. They came with me to the hospital in Pai. They paid for my, for the stitches and everything. It costed about 2,000 something baht. They paid it on the spot because I didn't have no money on me, and they trusted me to just go back to my place, and I paid them back right away. But it's just, I just really appreciate that, how they did that for me. And my homie Liam was there with me the whole time, so shout out to Liam. Really appreciate that, man, for real. I don't know when they're gonna let me out of the hospital, so it's a little bit confused right now. It's not clear right now when I'm getting out of here, but I have to upgrade my flight to business so I can put my foot up on the flight, and the insurance is gonna cover it or pay me back or whatever. But yeah, basically it was a pretty bad accident, pretty bad situation. But I'm glad I didn't. I mean, I'm still here. I'm talking. I'm breathing. I could see. It's just a little bit blurry, but I mean, I'm sure that's gonna go away. And just for everyone that's traveling, make sure you guys have insurance, because I'm telling you, you never know what's gonna happen. Either accidents or falls or whatever it is, just getting hurt. I almost had to pay $11,000 Canadian if I would have signed that paper and went through with that surgery. Like, they didn't, they were not trying to tell me what's your best choice. No, they were like, here, you have to do this. And when I saw the price, I said, whoa, like, no way, I can't afford that. I mean, obviously the last thing you're supposed to worry about right now is money, but that's the main thing I'm worrying about is money, because I don't want to be in a situation where I can't afford to pay for something that they already done and now I'm stuck here or something. Like, it's just a scary situation, man, but I'm glad it's over with. Now I just need to heal up, head back home. It's a long flight back home, but I mean, I've done worse. I made it through the hard part. I got to go back home and get surgery on my 3 fractures on my foot, because the alignment is pushed to the right. So my toes are supposed to be like this, but they're not. They're like this. And yeah, I mean, I'm ready for the surgery. I mean, I've been through the most pain I've probably ever been in my whole life. Those stitches that I got were excruciating pain. Like, I can't even explain. I would never wish that upon anyone. That was the worst experience ever. But yeah, I'll show you guys the room that I'm staying in also.
And there's a bathroom over there with a shower and a toilet.
And I mean, this room is very nice. I can't imagine it being anything under like $2,000 or $3,000 per night. Yeah, so it's definitely not cheap, but I'm just glad I have insurance, man. For real. Alright, so yo, I just got a fucking bath. I literally had a nurse come in here, take off all my clothes, put a towel over me, and just literally rub me down with like soap and water. Kind of uncomfortable. It's pretty weird. But I had to wipe my ass yesterday, and I fucking had a hard time, to be honest with you. It was pretty fucking hard. My vision is still blurry. I have to see the eye doctor at 5 o'clock today. Hopefully she can tell me something and tell me that it's normal, or say that it's going to go away soon, because I have an abrasion on my cornea. It's pretty, I mean, it's very normal. Not normal, but it's the most common eye injury. So it's not like something crazy, but it's fucking annoying. To have your vision blurry is the worst thing ever. Like, it's not even painful, it's just I can't see properly. If I close my eye, I can't read that sign right there. I can't read it, not at all. It's all blurry. So it's kind of annoying, to be honest with you. All right, so I'm about to get this massage type thing with this machine. I guess because my circulation is bad or something, I haven't moved my legs, so it's gonna prevent like blood clots and stuff. So this is gonna be pretty interesting.
Internet money, bitch.
Nick, you're stupid.
I wish that you would love me. I wish that you would love me more. Nobody else but me. Like, shawty, what you asking for? Hey, little bitch, I'm right here. Like, shawty, what you looking for? Yeah.
Pretty weird, but it's kind of like it's like pressure and it's vibrating slowly, and then it goes like harder. So it goes, it literally gets, it like fills it with air, like this one. It's filling with air right now, and now it's kind of shaking, vibrating my leg. And this one's off right now, so I guess this is super weird. I've never seen anything like this in my life. It's kind of crazy. Alright, so it's lunchtime now. This is the meal I just got. Well, I guess this is supper time, I'm not even sure. But this is supposed to be pork with some gravy, some onions in there, roasted potatoes, and some veggies. And this is
no clue what that is, but yeah.
You're all mine, all of mine. Calling and brawling all the time. Falling in love when it all ain't right. Crawling in my arms when you cry. I don't wanna love, I don't wanna fuck with you. Shawty, keep my love, shawty, keep my love with you. I know that I'm stuck, I know that I'm stuck with you.